subscribe our channel, press the bell icon for latest videos.
Hi friends, here in this video we are going to see Fourier's law of heat conduction, and for that let's get started. Fourier's law of heat conduction is the governing law for conduction equations, and I'll just write the statement and then explain what are the conclusions from Fourier's law. So this is the statement of Fourier's law. It states that the rate of heat transfer is directly proportional to the area normal, that is perpendicular to the direction of heat flow, and temperature gradient, that is the drop in temperature per unit length. In order to explain this law, first I'll draw the diagram. So here is a plane wall whose cross sectional area is denoted by capital A. Next, this wall is having thermal conductivity denoted by K, and the unit of thermal conductivity would be watts per meter Kelvin. Then this wall is having thickness denoted by dx. Next, there are two sides of the wall. Over one side the temperature is T1, and on the other side of the wall the temperature is T2, and here the assumption is T1 is higher than T2, or it is greater than T2, and in case of heat transfer, the heat always gets transferred from a region of high temperature to a region of low temperature. So the heat flow direction would be from T1 to T2, and as per the law of Fourier's, this heat transfer would be perpendicular, that is normal to the area of flow. So here, whatever the statement is written, that can be summarized in this way, that the rate of heat transfer is directly proportional to the area, and it is also directly proportional to the temperature gradient. Temperature gradient is the change in temperature denoted by dt, and dt is equal to T1 minus T2, the difference between higher temperature and the lower temperature. So heat transfer is directly proportional to the area, means if we have a greater value of area, there will be more amount of heat transfer. If we have greater amount of temperature gradient, temperature gradient is dt by dx, that is higher temperature difference and less thickness of wall, then there will be more amount of heat transfer. So therefore, when I write them by replacing the proportionality sign, there is a constant introduced. Where this constant K is called as the thermal conductivity of material, and here the material is there for the wall. Thermal conductivity is denoted by watts per meter Kelvin. Then negative sign indicates the drop in the temperature, that is the heat transfer continuously, it drops along the direction of flow. So negative sign indicates the drop in temperature along the direction of flow. That is, from T1 to T2, the temperature goes on continuously decreasing. And here the unit of heat transfer would be in terms of watts. And this law is the governing law for conduction, heat conduction, and it would be used further in the analysis as well as in the problems for conduction. So in this video, we have seen what is meant by Fourier's law of heat conduction. At the end, if you all find my videos helpful, you all can like, share, comment and subscribe our channel. At the same time, share it amongst your family and friends. Thanks for watching.